Hello everyone and welcome to QA Systems and Intland Software's webinar today. My name is Krzysztof Horvat. I am on Intland's marketing team and I will be moderating today's expert talk session. So first off, let me introduce our hosts for today. From QA Systems, we have Pierre-Henri Stanek on the webinar. Pierre-Henri is the country manager of QA Systems in France and is also a Contata product manager. He will be talking about dynamic testing and compliance with ISO 26262, and he will also show us how Contata and Codebeam ReLM can be used together. On the Intland side, we have Adam Chamourier, a pre-sales consultant and recent hire by Intland. And in today's webinar, Adam will show us how software safety requirements are managed in Codebeam ReLM and how lifecycle-wide traceability works out in practice in this platform. Right, so let's see what we have on the agenda today. After a short introduction of Intland software, I will take a few minutes to explain what Codebeam ReLM is. This is to help those coming in through QA systems better understand the value of what we're talking about today and the value of this integration between Contata and Codebeam ReLM. If you already know Codebeam ReLM, don't worry about it. This is just going to take a few minutes. Then I will move on to explaining how Codebeamer helps developers of automotive embedded systems. And I will briefly talk about how our platform supports compliance with ISO 26262 and other automotive standards. This will be followed by QA Systems presentation. Pierre-Henri will talk about ISO 26262 certified unit and integration testing, and he's going to dig deeper into the topic of dynamic testing under this standard. He'll also talk about the challenges of testing for this ISO 26262 standard. All this will be followed by a live demonstration of both Intland's Codebeam ReLM and QA Systems Contata. The demo will also showcase the seamless integration between these two powerful tools to help you really understand how all this works out in practice. And after the demo, we'll have some time for questions and answers. But please note that your questions are welcome anytime during the webinar. So just feel free to go ahead and use the questions box on your GoToWebinar control panel. We will be reviewing and attempting to answer all the questions that we find there at the end. Also, please note that there is going to be a recording of today's webinar available on Intland's website and sent to you via email. So don't worry about missing anything. Right, so before we start, let me give you a super quick introduction to Intland Software. Some of you might know the company, so let me keep this short. The company was founded in 1998 and, like QA Systems, is headquartered in Stuttgart, Germany. But we also have offices in the US and are represented by partners and resellers worldwide. Now, you might know some of our customers. To give you an idea of the companies that use Codebeam ReLM, here's a quick list. As you can see, the tool is heavily used by safety critical and high tech developers globally. Right, so what exactly is this tool? What is Codebeam ReLM? Well, let me help you understand by giving you a quick rundown of our platform. So in short, Codebeam ReLM is a holistically integrated application lifecycle management tool with features that cover the entire lifecycle. It's an all-in-one platform, which has many benefits over working with single-point tools. And lifecycle-wide traceability is one key advantage for developers operating in highly regulated industries, such as the automotive industry. These safety-critical companies really value some of our tools' main features and capabilities, such as process control, pre-configured templates, advanced reporting, and other features that support compliance. Codebeamer is also a TÜV trusted tool, which has been certified to support compliance with ISO 26262. Our platform works well with any development methodology, so whether you're using Agile, Waterfall, Scaled Agile, or a custom hybrid framework, you can use Codebeam ReLM, and it is also highly scalable and has strong quality assurance capabilities. So in short, Codebeamer helps you develop better products faster. Now let's see how exactly it does that. The next slide shows us some of the main components of Codebeam ReLM. Now, one important thing to note here is that the system was built organically integrated from the ground up. So basically, it's not just a set of standalone solutions glued together by interfaces. It uses a single central repository to store all your lifecycle data, which helps guarantee end-to-end traceability all the way from the inception of a product idea through to product release. The platform also offers collaborative features throughout the entire lifecycle and enables real-time access to information for all stakeholders. So essentially, Codebeamer lets you manage requirements, development, and manual or automated testing, and it also offers strong release management and DevOps capabilities. Everything that you do in Codebeamer is versioned, traced, and controlled to help you manage complexity. And so this is where things get interesting for automotive developers. Taming complexity is one key challenge here. Because of all the legacy software systems that are in use by automotive companies and their suppliers. So here, an open architecture is absolutely necessary. Now, Codebeamer ALM helps remove this tool friction by integrating well with other tools, either out of the box or using its fully documented API. You can just create custom integrations. And it can be used as a management layer, which provides collaboration and transparency across the entire lifecycle. So basically, whatever tools you use, you can just plug it into any development environment and you will achieve better process visibility and higher efficiency right away. Another important thing is that Intland Software also offers a pre-configured template for automotive developers to support compliance with automotive standards such as ISO 26262, IEC 61508, and Automotive SPICE. It also contains advanced approval and security features, risk management, and comprehensive QA functionality. Right, so enough of the talk. Before we move on to showcasing how Codebeamer ALM and Contada can be used together in automotive development, let me invite you to these two webinars on 24th and 25th of October, again with QA Systems. And before we do that, let me just ask a few very short and quick questions. First one's about the size of your team that you're working with. This will allow us to learn more about your environment. The next one, again, to help us learn more, is about the key challenges that you're facing right now. It seems like traceability is a challenge, so I think that you'll like what you're going to be seeing in the demo. And so let's move on to two more very short questions, and then I'm passing presenting rights over to Pierre Henry. Next one's about whether you're using an automated unit or integration testing framework currently. That's great, thank you. And so I have one last question. This is about the automotive safety integrity level that you're working towards. That's great, thanks a lot for your answers. And now I'm passing presenting rights over to Pierre Henry.
Good afternoon, everyone. I will be introducing to you the Contada solution edited by QoS Systems, which is a testing solution for software and especially embedded and critical software. Today, the topic is the ISO 262, so I will be presenting you the tool in accordance with the requirements of the standard, both for testing and as well for the requirements management. So let's have a start to look at the places where you can use Contada for improving your software quality. So first of all I will be presenting is in regards of the ISO 262 part 6, where most of the product development and testing requirements are defined. They are summarized in tables, which are tables 10 to 15, and all the practices requirements are asked against what we call the automotive safety integrity levels, which is the criticality level of your software. Contada can be used at the software unit testing level to ensure your basic Unix, so your functions, your methods, your small software components will be bug-free and comply, of course, with the low-level requirements to check that there is no undesired functionality. When you move on with the development and testing process, you will be integrating the units together into bigger blocks, which achieve more complex functions, and this will be the time for integration testing. At this place, it's important to pay attention to the interfaces, to the behavior of the software in the abnormal conditions. We will be talking about that a bit later. The end of the testing phase is the final verification of your system requirements or safety requirements at the validation stage. This is important because this will be the product finally released in the field, but Contalta will be of little help here because it's mostly a tool devoted to unit and integration tests. Let's have a look at the ISO 262 tables. So as I was saying before, they are categorized by safety criticality levels from A to D. D being the most difficult one, the most stringent for dangerous software. And what you see in front of you is a list of methods required to perform the verification of the software. When you say a plus, when you see a plus plus in a table, that stands for highly recommended, and a plus means simply recommended. The fact that it starts with 1A, with the requirement-based test, is not anecdotic, because everything needs to start from the requirement. You should not design tests which are not attached and verifying a certain functional requirement of your software. So requirement-based test is important. You have to make sure that you develop tests that they are keep in synchronization with the requirements, that the results of the tests are associated to the verification of a certain requirement. And this is why we have performed the integration of Contalta with Cobib, that you will be seeing later during the demonstration. The other techniques and methods are important as well. As I was saying, the more it goes in testing and integration, the more interface testing is important. And you will be seeing that Contalta has special technology to comply with the interface tests. Fault injection as well, which is a very important topic, which is relatively hard to perform in everyday activities, because on average, doing fault injection requires quite a lot of hardware setup. And you will be seeing how it works today with a software fault injection technique. There are more classical techniques and methods defined by the ISO 262, which are the equivalence classes, the boundary values, the error guessing. They are not specific to ISO 262. Most of the standards, DO178 for avionics, IEC 61508 and the others, they define the same. But they are good techniques. They are proven in the industry. And we have done our best at QS Systems to provide you automation for implementing the verification corresponding to these techniques. All what we have discussed just before is about the black box testing. Black box testing means you verify what the software does. So you verify its intent, the functional requirements in a black box way. White box testing is very important for two reasons. First of all, you will see how the tests are executed, how your software is executing against the verification. So it's to verify that you have no branch, no path in your application that are forgotten, and even worse than that, that you have no dead code in your application. White box testing is very important as well, because this is a way to stop doing black box testing. When you do black box testing, you could test with values a little bit forever, because which one is more relevant than another? It could be quite infinite. If you plug the coverage verification in your test activities, you will be giving the certitude that all your functional tests are exercising the entirety of the software. Thus, you can stop testing. Safety standards, including ISO 262, they defined coverage levels you should reach and achieve, depending one more time on the criticality of the software. So you see from ASIL A to D, you are not supposed to do the same thing, the most complex one being MCDC, which is required by level A. In Contalta, of course, we define coverage sets for every of these single levels up to the MCDC, and they are fully automated to let you save time. It's very important because, for instance, MCDC verification at level D is very time consuming. I have seen people multiplying the time of testing by two just to reach 100% of MCDC on their software. So good tooling here is very helpful and cost effective in order to perform the right verification in a cost saving way. Let's talk about testing a little bit more in general. There are a series of challenges. There are more than that, but they are the most famous and classical challenges associated to testing. It's all about how you integrate your test bench with the rest of your development environment, how you can trace requirement to test, which is the topic of the session today, how you can bring as much automation as you can to make tests cost-savvy, how you can do a good interface testing, because this is the place where a lot of errors occur, and how a good coverage can be performed as well, as we've just discussed in the slide before. I will be just talking about each of these topics individually. Tool integration first. When you deal with safety critical software, quite often, not to say always, at some point, you need to be in what we call the operational conditions for the execution of the tests. That means you have to run on target. So it's a common problematic which has to be addressed. How can you plug your test environment with your target to run the tests with your ECU, with your CPU, and so forth? In Cantata, we have a solution for that, which is the deployment. The deployment is a bit of glue in the product to accommodate any choice of compiler linker for your CPU and any target with any connectivity, serial link, an Ethernet, a JTAG, whatever you want. The idea is to build the software in the way you build for the construction of your application, deploy the tests on the CPU and collect the results back from the target memory to produce the test evidences. So that's very important, and we provide you a mechanism for automating the target deployment. But it's not only that. Testing like development has a much broader scope. If we talk, for example, about the V-cycle, when you start unit testing, you are supposed to have verified in the first place your code by applying, for example, static analysis. It's very important in the automotive domain, for example, where you need to comply with the MISRA rules, and you may use, for example, a tool like QAC and QAC++ to enforce that you are respecting the MISRA programming rules. If you do that, it's good to keep the synchronization between the static results and the dynamic results. So when you test dynamically your software with Cantata and you fix bugs, it's good to check at the same time that you have not violated a new MISRA rule because you have modified your software to fix a bug, for instance, and the other way around. Talking about the application lifecycle management, there are a lot of different activities which are all important. Integrating your software with continuous integration, so a solution like Jenkins, for instance, doing the software configuration management, the bug tracking, the requirements management and traceability. So we need to be integrated with all of that. So today I will be showing you how we are integrated with CodeBeamer using the CodeBeamer server and the surrounding technology. It can be as well thanks to Eclipse or other open source APIs, JSON connectors, and all of that. We have the necessary connectors and technology in Cantata not to be stuck when we want to integrate with SCM, RQM, and bug tracking environment. For the people in the audience who are software developers, a very important topic as well is to be able to work with your choice of IDE. So in the automotive world, maybe you are familiar with Tasking, IAR, Kyle, Lauterbach, and so forth. We are integrated with all these solutions. As a professional company in this domain, we have made the integration with all necessary major players that's produce IDEs for the development. Automation. As I was saying before, automating the test is very important. Otherwise, it costs a lot when you have to manually develop your test environment and then implement the test framework by yourself. Automating means different things. That means, first of all, make sure that you can set up an environment, automate the build of the code, and so forth. But not only. In Cantata, we have the capability to go beyond and provide what we call auto test in order to be able to generate test data automatically by analyzing your C or C++ code. The thing is, we have now powerful tools for the code analysis, and these tools can be used in order to understand what are the execution branches and trigger the necessary parameters, variables, function calls in order to make this execution almost complete, that is the target at least, in terms of test generation. I will not spend a lot of time today about auto test because next week We have another webinar organized with Intland that will be showing you autotests in the context of the requirements management traceability as well. So I encourage you to assist to this webinar if you want to know more. In the demonstration, I will be doing the tests manually. That will be quite interesting for you to see what you need to do when you start from scratch with a new requirement and a new piece of code which is associated to this requirement. Control of interfaces. As I was saying before, when we leave the realm of unit testing to reach integration testing, by binding components one to each other, you tend to detect flaws and bugs at the interfaces of these components. So it's important to have a good technology to interface the various components and check what's happening at these interfaces. In Cantata, like any other tool, we have stubs, simulations. So this is very classical. You will find that everywhere. But we go a little bit beyond that. We have the wrappers, which are not simulators of compilation units. We are using the real compilation units. So your third-party libraries, system calls, for instance. But we are wrapping them in order to check the in and out parameters. And more interesting, we can hack, we can modify these parameters. It's a nice way, an easy way, a software mechanism for seeing what happens when you reach certain limit conditions and when you want to perform a software fault injection to see how the software will react to this fault. So you can perform message mutilation, you can do a RAM bit flip, you can do a lot of different things. And then you can see how your defensive code and the error management is done in your software. And this is asked by ISO 26002, and it's a very important topic. I will be covering that during my demonstration a little bit as well. Code coverage, as I was saying before, every safety standard, including ISO 26002, will require certain coverage rules to be implemented and reach at 100% in order to get the certification in place. We will deliver to you all the rule sets for level A to D, so you don't have to worry about that. They are automated in terms of code instrumentation, and we are producing both interesting mechanisms for instrumentation, but as well for the reporting. So on the right hand side of the slide here, you can see a nice colorful report that shows the code as green when it has been executed, red as still to be executed, so not executed, and orange when you have a partial execution, like for example, a Boolean or complex conditions. We'll provide you with metrics, rates, all of that in the form of XML, HTML, textual report, in order to provide the test evidences. Reporting. Reporting is very important, especially in the context of collaborating with tools. And this is why today we will see a nice collaboration environment with CodeBeamer. Cantata is not only a desktop product. It is by nature a desktop product because it works on the machine of the developer who performs the unit test and the integration test. But we can as well aggregate all the coverage results, the test results, onto a server. This server will timestamp everything, will show you history and trends about the results. You can filter that, you can export the results, and it's a nice way for project leaders and managers to see the progression of the test effort. The server is interesting as well because it can as well record everything related to the requirements. You will be seeing soon that we can import requirements into Cantata. Once the import has been made and we have made association with the Cantata test cases, the server can aggregate all of that together and then report to the external world, in this case, to the CodeBeamer environment. Requirements traceability, which is the important topic for today. So ISO 26002 is recommending in terms of methods, we have seen that in the tables, to perform requirement-based tests. So it's important to be able to import the requirements inside the tool in order to be able to associate these requirements with your test scripts and test cases. So from CodeBeamer, you can export the requirements in the form of a standard file, which is a RECIF file that stands for Requirements Interaction Format. And once it is done, you have the possibility in the tool to drag and drop the requirements to make the associations to the tests. You run your test, you collect results, both functional and code coverage results, and then all these results can be reported back into CodeBeamer when you can do the traceability, see the coverage of your requirements, the results, and so forth. And this is what you will be seeing in my demonstration. Thank you. I'm done for my part. If you have questions, feel free to ask. So I see a question about the wrappers. Indeed, the wrappers, the question is, how do you define the wrappers? Is it on a per function or per method basis? It's exactly that. So we will be doing the wrapping of your calls, wherever they are from the software under test or for the third party software or libraries. And we will be doing the in-memory verification of the parameters and return values. At what level of the software is the wrapper defined? At any level, except that for the level D, which is the most stringent for ISO 262, you have to be able to justify that the wrappers are used in order to perform verifications that could not be performed otherwise. Because you need to remember that they perform instrumentation, and instrumentation of the software implies that you are modifying the software that is actually on target, and that's requiring a little bit more documentations and justifications for your certification authority. The last question I got is, which operating systems are supported? We are supporting Linux, all the recent kernels, and we are supporting Windows, from Windows 7 up to the most recent Windows releases. Knowing that, I talk here about the development machines, the place where you develop your tests, and we have no limitation for the on-target execution. And whatever you connect, any type of CPU family and type of core, it will be integratable in Cantata. Thank you. I have answered the questions. There is one more time, another question. How is the mockup for the hardware defined? Do you use one for architecture? A little bit, it's a little bit like that indeed. When we do a deployment, we have the notion of configuration. So you will be seeing in the first place, if you use a Kyle compiler, for example, or an IAR1 and so forth, it will create for you a template where you can define the compiler linker specifics in terms of memory mapping, compilation flags, and so forth. And once it is done, there is another part of the deployment architecture, which is how we flash the code, how we deploy the code on target, and how we get back the results from the memory. All of that is done in Eclipse. We have an offering tool in the form of a deployment editor, which is documented, that you can use by yourself. You are not dependent on QA systems if you want to make your own deployment. On the other way, if you prefer not to do it by yourself, it's perfectly possible. And we will be doing that in the form of professional services for you. What is important is at the end of the deployment, you get a checksum, which is the guarantee of the integrity of your deployment in terms of results and functions. And this checksum will be used against the AZ levels to show that your runtime environment is safe in terms of test execution and test results. Thank you. I need to stop now in terms of questions because we have still two demonstrations, and otherwise we will be a bit late.
Thank you very much. We will have more time for questions at the end. So if you have any questions in the meantime, please just go ahead and type them in the questions box.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pierre-Henri. And we'll be giving it over to Adam.
Okay, so hello, everyone. My name is Adam Shomore, and I'm going to show you the CodeBeamer functionality in terms of the ISO regulatory standard. Based on the requirement and testing. So some of you might already know CodeBeamer, but let me highlight that CodeBeamer is a 100% browser-based solution, which practically means that you can access CodeBeamer in any type of browser, and it can be hosted as an on-premise or as a cloud-based solution. And today we are going to use our cloud instance, which is running on an Amazon cloud server. So now we are in the login page, and if I click on login, being redirected to the project browser, where I can see all my projects that I'm the member of, and each item represents a fully pre-configured project covering one specific lifecycle, which can support a Wii model, agile, or a hybrid methodology, and so on. And on the left-hand side, you can see the projects grouped into categories. And in the middle here, as I just showed you, you can see the recently opened projects. And for today's presentation, I'm going to open up our automotive demo project, which is being pre-configured according to the ISO 26262 regulatory standards. So let me just open it. And the very first page when I enter a Codebeamer project is the wiki page of that project. Here in the wiki, you can define a navigation for your stakeholders with the direct links, and this is where you describe the content of your project. So this is basically a knowledge base for the later. And here you can see an overview of the ISO 26262 regulatory standard. You can check what is the vocabulary that we are using and other relevant informations. And of course, in the end, you can have some direct links into the project components. And then if I click onto one of the pages, let's say it is a text content or the wiki content again, and this is an example, a simple process which will be enforced by the system during the project lifecycle. So these are the steps you need to follow in order to stay compliant to the standards. Also, you can keep track of the various KPIs which you identified into your project, and it can be collected and visualized in a nice dashboard with our built-in widgets like bar charts or pie charts. And for example, here you can see the assignment of all the open items in the current release, so you can make project relevant information easily available to all your project members. And just by mentioning the project members, under the admin and members tab, you can have a clear and transparent view of who is part of this project. As in Codebeamer, everything happens through a strict permission control. Here you can see the pre-configured roles listed here. And every user can be assigned to one or many roles at the same time within a project. And this is basically defines what information these users will have access to and what actions they can make in the system later. And we arrived to the tracker structure, which is the main business object here in Codebeamer. And this is what representing the real traceability in Codebeamer. And the starting point from the highest level of the item definition, you can really build up a development model. This means that tracker basically is a Codebeamer specific term and is a logical container for work items. For each and every tracker, there is a pre-configured workflow in place. So if I just navigate to the software safety requirements, which we are going to use today, I can check the workflow diagram behind just by clicking on this item. And with this function, I can visualize easily the lifecycle that each and every software safety requirement will go through in the system. As you can see, this is a very basic workflow, but it can be easily configured in Codebeamer just by clicking on the Customize option here. And just to make sure that you are compliant in your development process, you need to have such workflow engine defined. And just to demonstrate, if I click into one of the single state transition, I can also specify who can, for example, accept these requirements, which is based on the workflow. I can set it based on individual users and can set it based on the rules I have listed here according to the project settings. And this way, I believe it's pretty easy to specify the permission rights and sets and who is responsible for what in the project. And from here, if I go to the detailed view of the requirement, the software safety requirement, on the left-hand side, I can see the structure of my software safety requirements. And in this view, I can easily implement a hierarchy with parent and child relations. So for example, if I click on this folder, I can create a new child easily just by clicking onto this option. But now I don't create it, I just click on one of the requirements here. And we can see that right upon the selection, I see here the content of my requirement, the title, the short description, and an image. And on the right hand side, I can see some various different attributes which I can change easily here in the system, and I can click on save. So it's pretty straightforward. And to build up the traceability, I can simply click on this plus button next to the requirement. And based on the underlying configuration, I allow to derive items from one single requirement. And now I can see all the available ones. And if I would like to derive a test case, I just simply need to click on this test case row. And in the pop-up window, in the verifies field, I can see a link back to the original requirement. And I can also set the propagate status, propagate suspects optional status, which means that whenever I change the software requirement, the suspected link turns into red, and that is basically a flag or a notification of the system that I might not be consistent in the development process. So to say, one of the biggest benefits of having an ALM solution is the full traceability. If we are going to the tracker's overview back, now we can see that starting from the item definition, that means probably the highest level of the item you will define, and then you address the hazards, the safety goals, and other requirements. I can show you the connections between these items with the traceability browser functionality. So if I click on this icon, we can use a preset, which is already set in the system. So I can choose the software traceability. So I will see the connection between the item definition and hazard safety goals through the software safety requirements and then the software test. So if I just simply click on this, I can see the levels as an overview, and I can see how many items each level has. So for example, if I have 9 item definitions, 2 hazards, 3 safety goals, and so on. And here you can clearly see that steering angle sensor has an incoming link or connection with this steering angle sensor failure hazard, and it has 2 connected safety goals, which has other safety requirements, and we can drill down till the software tasks as well. And please note that here we can see again the suspected links, which means whenever you see a suspected option, it is checking the higher level requirement status. If that requirement has been changed ever since you set up the link, then the suspected link will turn into red, as we can see here. And this is a notification again that you might not be consistent in your processes. And using these links, side by side comparison, you can compare different versions to each other, and based on that, you can easily make a decision whether you are consistent or not. So basically, that's it what I wanted to show you. So here's the point where I would go back to the tracker's overview and hand it over to my colleague to present how CodeBeamer is supporting the test automation if you have all these requirements set up in the system. So thank you.
Thank you. And we're now passing it back to Pierre-Henri.
Thank you. Okay. So let's come back to CodeBeamer. So as Adam was just saying, I will be starting my demonstration from the list of requirements, from the requirements tracker. And we will be implementing a test for one of them, which is the total weight here must be less than 1,100 kilograms. As I was saying in my presentation, in the first place, in order to let Cantata work with the requirements, you have to perform an export. You will be exporting the requirements from the admin section of the tool here. So you go there, you click the export section, and you pick up the requirements interaction format archive. That is a standard XML format used by tools to collaborate with each other. So we will be importing into Cantata this RECIF file. So we select the software safety requirements, which contain the one which is relevant for me. You can pick up different fields, the most important one being the ID, the summary, of course, of the requirements to let Cantata display this information. So we say OK, and we save this file onto my computer. Now I go to Cantata. Cantata is an Eclipse tool. We have decided to base our development on Eclipse because Eclipse is a very popular development environment since several years already. It can be used in conjunction with other tools easily because we have a lot of other vendors which are basing their tooling on Eclipse as well. What you can see here is the general layout of the tool. On the left-hand side, you have the Project Explorer, which contains the various test projects with the code to be tested. And then there will be several windows that I will be presenting to you one after each other. The first one I want to show you is the trace window. The trace window is the place where in Cantata you will be importing requirements and trace them to certain test scripts and test cases. So when you are in trace, the first thing you will perform here on top is to import requirements. So you specify the format. You may use Excel or other things, but for us, for a professional solution, it's a RECIF import. Then we create a requirement set. We can call it demo Wednesday, for example. And then we will be picking up the file that I have just exported from the CodeBeamer tool. So as soon as I pick up the file, you will see that Cantata has detected that it contains requirements, and these requirements are named software safety requirements because they come from the project that we have managed in CodeBeamer. I click OK, I create the new requirement set, and then it puts the requirements as a list that you can see here. There is more than that, actually, because they have all the requirements of the project for different modules, the firmware manager, the audio engine, the media browser, a lot of different things. If you are interested in a requirement and you want to read what it is, you simply double-click, and Cantata will display the requirements description along with pictures and diagrams if you have pictures and diagrams for it. Okay, so you can open different ones and review. As a tester, my responsibility is to test the weight of the vehicle. So I filter on weight, and I will be selecting this first set of requirements because they correspond to the software I want to verify. Once I have done that, I will be going then to the traceability window. But as right now, as you can see, we have no test. We have not designed any tests. We will abandon the trace view a little bit, and we will go with the associations once we have generated tests for it. Let's talk about the code. It's simple code. It's just to illustrate how the tool works. So we will be computing the weight of a car, which is a structure, a pointer on a structure to be accurate. And then we will compute the total weight based on the number of model parts by factor, which is the type of metal. Is it iron or is it aluminium, and so forth. So we can start, for example, with iron here for the code. What is interesting for you as potentially a developer is that Cantata can analyze code, understand it, and manipulate relatively complex data in an easy way. As you can see here, the car is a structure that contains a string, an array, some doubles. It manipulates an enum as well. And all of that will be passed as a pointer of my function. So it's not over complicated, but it's already a bit elaborated. And it could be tedious to do such a test by hand. if you would use no tool or open source tooling, for instance. So in the first place, when you start testing with Cantata, you pick up the code. So here I have just one C file, but it could be a collection of C or C++, a mix potentially, if you perform integration testing. Once I have selected my file under test, then there is an icon here in my environment to generate the test script. So at the back, we do an analysis of the code. So when I'm here in the wizard for generating the test script, I know what the code is. And then Cantata will offer different generation patterns for the tests. The first one is known, which is not nothing. That means it will generate a project, which is a template with the structure, and then the tester will have to implement the test cases by hand, which is sometimes quite useful if you are very, very familiar with the tool. Test case per function is a very classical generation mechanism because this is unit testing. It's testing in isolation every single function or method of the code and generates a test case for it. The parameters will be null values, as you will be seeing in my demonstration. If you want to get test vectors, which are non-null, which contains relevant data, you have to switch to autotest. And then the tool will compute the test vectors based on the coverage that you want to achieve for your software verification. One more time, there will be a demonstration next week, so I skip autotest and I concentrate on test case per function. As I was saying before, in order to comply with ISO 262, you have to provide coverage evidences at different levels. We have prepackaged the different coverage levels depending on the ASIL level. Let's take for this example the most difficult one, which is the ASIL D, that will contain, for instance, the MCDC verification. I do next, and Cantata will show me the code interface control. So that means what are the functions or methods external to my unit under test that I may want to interface in order to perform simulation in the form of a stub or make in-out verification and fault injection for a wrapper, for instance. So in my small piece of code, there are two externs. The first one is printf, which comes from the standard C library, so I'm not very keen to simulate that. But the other one is interesting. It's a checkweight function, which is called in my module under test. And by default, Cantata is offering to stub it out. Knowing that, you can change the control, for example. If you go there for the wait state, you could say that it's a wrapper instead of a stub. And then it will keep the real function and do a wrapper, or in this case, it will simulate this wrapper out. I click finish and it will generate automatically the test case for me. I will put it on the left hand side here to simplify a little bit the view of what we do. There is one single test case because I have only one single function in my code. And when I click this test case, Cantata brings up the test case editor, which is really our offering environment for designing the tests. The test case editor is dividing the test script into five different sets of entities that you need to manipulate. Some of them are mandatory, some of them are optional. Obviously, the one which is mandatory is the SUD call, software under test call. You will be calling the total weight function, which is under test, with a parameter, this parameter being a pointer on the car structure, as you can see here. As I was saying, Cantata by default put a null value, but you will see how we will design simply a nice test in a few clicks. Then you can manipulate the data for the in and out variables and parameters, the global variables as well. You will do checks, verifications, and if you want to, you can have pre and post conditions which are executed before and after the current test. The view is rather simple. It's a tabular view where you can see the type. It's very interesting for a developer because you see directly the C or C++ type you are testing against. Then you put an initialization value and an expected one against which we will perform a pass-fail verification when we run the tests. As I was saying, I'm testing a pointer. So the nice thing with it is it's dynamic data that we need to allocate. It's not just a variable like an integer that will be a static one. So we will create dynamically the pointer using the malloc method onto the structure char. And when I do that, as you can see, Cantata automatically is creating the pointer on the structure. And we can see the different elements of the structure. So the structure contains an array of integers, which is the char unique ID. So for example, you could type the various the element of the array. Of course, we have a mechanism. If you click on top here, you will be able to fill entirely the array. You can modify the size. I will not do an exhaustive demo. I want to show you briefly how it works. Let's type a name for the vehicle. Let's say it's a Q3 car, for example. How many parts it has? 800 parts. I expect the weight to be 800 at the end of my computation. And thus, the return value here, we will be saving the things here. The return value is supposed to be valid because this is not a heavy car. So you see in a few clicks, I have set up all the things. I have set up a complex structure with all its parameters, its fields, sorry, the strings, the doubles, the array, and so forth, and the return value, which is an enum. It's a weight state, which is an enum. And you see that there was no programming. I was not obliged to make C or C++ programming. It's all either a predefined or compatible values that you will be inserting in this test case editor. So this is it. Once you have done that, then you will run the test. So you have saved your test and you will do a run as here, Cantata test. And then automatically, the tool will be taking, thanks to the deployment, your compiler linker and generate code for your target CPU. It will be then produce an executable that will be either execute locally here. Oops, sorry. This is a small execution thing. Okay, maybe there was, probably one of my defines inside. Oh yes, it's here. I have not saved the pointer as I should have. I'm sorry about that. I have probably forgotten to save my object. That's a small demo effect that occurs from time to time. So let's redo that. 800. The weight is 0 and expected to 800 at the end. Okay. We'll be checking that this time the structure is there with the right data. Yes. Okay. Let's do the run again and we'll see what happens. Okay. So I'm generating the code. I'm compiling it and deploying the code onto the execution environment and generate results. So as you can see, there is a first textual information in our console that says that my test failed. We will see a little bit later why. The coverage rule set is passing, so the coverage execution is doing well. It's more something to do with the test. So you can explore the results here from the Eclipse interface as a developer, or you can use CodeBeamer and our server to explore the results as well. So I will be using CodeBeamer instead of Cantata to show a little bit more how all this information is all integrated into the CodeBeamer environment. Let's come back to Trace. This is the place where we had defined the import of the requirements. And now I have a test case and a test script. They appear here. As I was saying before, I will associate this test case to the requirements that we want to test, which is I want my car to be less than 1,100 kilograms. And in theory, here it should be 800. So as you have seen, I have drag and drop to make the association. And you can do that with any test scripts and cases you have in the tool with any requirements. So it's a many-to-many association. Once you have made the associations, then you click the export button, and then automatically, it will be exporting back to CodeBeamer the results. So now, as you can see, it's exporting to CodeBeamer. I can switch to CodeBeamer, and inside my trackers, when you are using the Cantata, now you have a new tracker on top of the existing trackers, which is the Cantata test cases. you can see that we have created a new test case, which is the test weight. The test weight is associated and verifies the total weight must be 1,000 kilogram or less requirements. And this has been automatically reported into the CodeBeamer environment. This test case, will contain a test run. As you can see, it has been submitted by me at this time from the Cantata tool, and there is a test run associated to it, which corresponds to my execution into Cantata. And as we can see, it fails. Unfortunately, it fails. So if I click the run test weight, I will be able to see from the run tracker the global result, which is unfortunately right now a failure, and an assessment of the coverage. Here, we can see directly the coverage results, but we just see globally that the test case fails. And if we want to see why, we can click on this link from CodeBeamer, and it will pop up the Cantata server where you can explore what has happened. As you can see here in the Cantata server, the weight was expected to be 800, and actually it's 1,600. So unfortunately for me, I have a bug in my code. So in my code, if I come back here, I was wrong. My Q3 car is not an iron car. It's an aluminium car. So I will fix my code here with aluminium, save the code, then run the test again. Check that this time it goes through. So as you can see now, it's passing. And then from trace, we will be exporting again. As you can see now, it's green because it's passing. So we export again to CodeBeamer, the new result. And now when I go to the CodeBeamer environment and I come back to CodeBeamer, if I have a look at the different test runs, I have the old one, which was failing, and the new one, which is passing. So when you are, because it's very important for you in the requirements coverage view, so if I come back to the software safety requirements we had in the beginning, and if we trigger into CodeBeamer the test coverage, then if we open the project, we will be seeing here in the total weight that this test case is passing as expected. And this is the end of my demonstration flow. Thank you.
Thank you, Pierre-Henri. And so now it's time for the questions. So we'll be waiting a couple of minutes. Please feel free to type any questions you might have in the questions box on your GoToWebinar control panel. There's one new question that I see here, Pierre-Henri, which is about users asking whether they can use auto-generated test cases for certification.
Yes, it's perfectly possible. It's all about you make the right associations with the requirements. It's perfectly valid to have an automatic tests as a test evidence, as long as there is a human being, an engineer, which makes the association with a functional requirement and which is verifying that this automatic generated test is indeed covering, verifying a certain requirement. So if there is a human review in the process, then it's perfectly feasible to use an automatic test as a test evidence for a certification process.
All right, thank you. Now, if you look at the questions box, there's another new question. Why are you using Rekif for the transfer from CodeBeamer to Cantata, and from Cantata to CodeBeamer, you have an automated interface?
Yeah, it's a good question. That may change in the close future. It's because we have very diverse customers using different requirement management solutions. And so using Rekif as an import for us is very convenient because there are several tools and technology who can export Rekif, and therefore we can import Rekif. For the export, as you have seen, we have something which is much smarter because it does automatically the push using the CodeBeamer API in the right tracker for the results and everything. I understand your question, and I agree that it might be relevant for us to have something equivalent for the import. But we have at this time made a reuse of the existing technology, which fits as well the CodeBeamer environment. So we have been a bit pragmatic for an initial integration. That's why. Can we export to Reclif? So there is another question. It's possible to right now it's hard coded. The fact that we do the export in the form of the API, but the Reclif export is in the product. So if you want, if you think it's relevant for you, we could imagine that in the product, in the final version of the product, we offer the possibility not to automatically export using the API, but to have a manual Reclif export if needed. It would complexify a bit the thing, but if it makes sense for you as a use case, this is something we can discuss and implement easily in the product because it's already there. It's just not used right now in the current interface.
Okay, it seems like we're out of questions for now. So Pierre-Henri and I'd like to thank you for your contribution and also thanks everyone for your attention. Please make sure you sign up for next week's webinar and don't forget that if you have any questions after the webinar, feel free to reach out to us and we'll take it offline and have your questions answered. Right, so thanks for your attention and thanks Adam and Pierre-Henri for your contribution. I'll see you next week. Thank you. Goodbye.